Hi, Tammy C. Walker here, life coach, therapist, social worker, owner of dreamsareareality.com. Subscribe, subscribe, subscribe to my channel, and please hit that like button. Today we're going to talk about how to raise your self-esteem. This is one of the most asked questions that I get. I'm on this website called Quora, and I tell you, every day someone is saying, how do I raise my self-esteem? I have low confidence. Raising self-esteem is totally an inside job. I think from my understanding of self-esteem, it comes from how you're raised. Maybe you had parents that had high self-esteem, or if they, you know, kept you well-groomed. These are things that make you feel good about yourself, because that's what it's all about. Self-esteem is about feeling good about yourself, positive, confident. You're not easily rattled by words, or if somebody says something negative to you, it kind of rolls off your back like they say water rolls off a duck's back. It's the same way when your self-esteem, it's nothing too much anybody can say, because you know you the shit, honestly. Okay, so first things first, to have high self-esteem, you want to be kind to yourself. If you don't love yourself, we can't put all of this pressure on someone else to love us if we think lowly of ourselves. If we're fishing for compliments, we're always looking for approval. That's tired and played out, and people get tired of that. They get tired of trying to feed your ego. So you have to be kind to yourself by lighting some candles, taking you a nice hot bath, listening to some soft music or your favorite music, buy your favorite meal, you know, have you a nice glass of wine, nice cup of coffee, nice cup of tea. Go to the movies and see a movie alone. Have a nice breakfast alone. Self-love. Manicure. I was going to say manicure. I'm bringing my work into this. Manicure. Pedicure. I mean, take care of yourself. A massage. Give yourself a facial. I have this clay mask by Freeman. I give it to myself twice a week. I put the mask on my own face. You know, whatever it is for self-care, which is self-love. If you don't love yourself, you know, it's almost like you can't expect anyone else to do that for you. So treat yourself kind, be kind and gentle. Number two, work out. Can't go wrong when you moving that body, getting those happy endorphins going and moving the blood through your body. You don't have to go be crazy trying to be the Incredible Hulk or Hulk Hogan. You know, that whole workout stigma where you got to go do 40 billion jumping jacks, 20,000 burpees, lift 1 billion pounds. It's just silly to me. 30 minutes a day, 3 times a week. You want to bump it up, do 30 minutes times 5. Do 60 minutes times 3. It's not a competition against anybody but yourself. You're just trying to keep that blood flowing, keep the heart rate up, release happy endorphins. 3 times a week, bump it up. Walk. You can swim, tennis, volleyball, Zumba, the gym, you know, treadmill, elliptical, rowing. I love that. Rowing machine is one of the best to me. It's just so many things you can do. Weights are the best. Simple walking again. One of the best exercises. Do you, boo. That's what everything in life. Do you. Don't try to do what your friend does. Do you. And you're going to feel much better about yourself because you're going to be more fit. Let's see. Number three, be with nature. Can't go wrong watching a squirrel go get his little nuts. Get his little nuts and stick it in his cheeks. And I mean, you just can't go wrong. Can't go wrong with nature. Think about a bird. When the mama bird sees that her chick can fly, what does she do? Get on out of here, little baby birdie. She makes the nest uncomfortable and pushes them out. So it shows you that animals know the flow, the progression of life. Even as humans, we don't kick our birdies out the nest, do we? So watch nature. Animals take just enough food. They don't overindulge. I think humans can learn so much from nature. So be with nature. I live by a pond, and it's getting warmer here outside of Chicago. So I like to hang out at the pond. I look at the water. I walk around. I do some laps around, watch the ducks. It's just such a surreal time. Or is it serene? Both of them, I believe. But anyway, stay positive and say positive things about yourself. when I walk past the mirror, if I know, like, you know how you have on your favorite shirt or maybe your favorite necklace, or my niece, she does my hair for me, and she's 32, I'm 48, so she keeps me young and hip. I'm like, you look good today. You killing it. You got to compliment yourself. I think people, they get on Facebook and they're looking for compliments. You better know you look good for yourself. You look good, man. I know I'm killing it. Look at my shoe game. Look at this. Look at, you know, brag on yourself to yourself. And it makes you feel good. It really does. Number five, posture. Hold your head up. Be proud of who you are. Be proud of your heritage. If you're Indian, you're African American, black. I'm from the 70s. We say black. If you're Latina, Latino, be proud. If you're Caucasian, be proud of where you came from, Irish, whatever. Own your heritage. Hold your head up high. My parents were from the South. Mobile, Alabama for my dad, and Clarksdale, Mississippi for my mom. They were very proud people, good-looking people. I had good-looking parents. God rest both of their souls. But they were proud, and they kept us well-groomed. They kept our hair nice with pretty ponytails, nice dresses, clothes, clean home. So grateful to my parents. So own it. Hold your head up high. Be proud. That's part of self-confidence and self-esteem, is being proud of who you are, the posture. This is really one of the biggest tips to me, one of them. Number six, dress to impress, baby. I wear jeans to work, you know, but I put on a cute shirt. My shirt got a little hood on it. Nothing fancy. I think it's kind of cute. You can't really tell. It's a little bit different kind of material. Anyway, if you want to wear jeans, I wear a little heel with it, and I just try to look cute. I make sure my makeup is cute. I don't overdo it. And I had a lady walk up to me, and she was like, I don't wear makeup. I'm like, no, I don't know what she wanted from me, but that's you. Do you, boo. You don't have to wear makeup, but I choose to wear it, and I love it. So own it, rock it, dress for success, wear your suits, your cute shoes, your sandals, your nice tops. Do you, and dress to succeed. That is so important about raising your self-esteem. Get some new clothes. Spring is here. Get some new clothes. Number seven, meditate. Can't go wrong with that. Deepak Chopra and Oprah Winfrey have a free meditation that started a few days ago. So you can jump in. It's probably on day 11. But it's on their website. You just type in free meditation, Oprah Winfrey or Deepak. Either one, it'll pull it up. It's free. You will love it. It raises your vibration. This time it's about grace. Can't go wrong with grace. Also, I journal. Pen to the paper is magic. I want to pay off my car. I want to pay off my student loan. I want to get married. I want to lose weight. I want to finish my book. I want to get my LSW. Write down whatever your goals are. Write them down. Oh, I write the same stuff over and over, over and over. And it's like I smile when I see them coming to fruition. Pen to the paper. Journaling is magic. So these are all of my 8 steps for raising your self-esteem. You can do it. I believe in you. I appreciate every person that watches my video. Subscribe, like, pass me on, not pass me on, pass my video on to someone else, at, you know, anyone else that I can help. If you do want to do a Skype session, www.dreamsarereality.com. Subscribe for me. Okay, thank you so much for watching. Raise your self-esteem. Own it. Know that you are loved and worth it. Bye. Till we see each other again. Take care.